I'm honored to join this year's National Prayer Breakfast. Jill and I are humbled by your prayers, and it means everything to us. I want to thank our dear friend from my home state of Delaware, a man of deep faith, Senator Chris Coons. We've been friends a long time. Thank you also to the fellow bipartisan co-chairs of this year's breakfast, Senator Tim Scott and Representative Tom Suozzi, and John Molinar. You know, Ambassador Andrew Young, a national treasurer who speaks the good news and does the good deeds, thank you for your continued friendship. You're the best. And I'm also grateful for the predecessors who are part of this year's program, President Carter, President Bush, President Clinton, and President Obama. And I'm honored to continue this tradition of reflection and fellowship that started with President Eisenhower. You know, I've attended many of these prayer breakfasts over the years, with a nation at war and struggle and strife, a nation at peace and in prosperity, a nation, though, always in prayer. But we know this time is different. Over 400,000 of our fellow Americans have lost their lives to a deadly virus. Millions are out of work. We see long lines for food at food banks that stretch for miles. We hear the call for racial justice, some 400 years in the making, and we know the dream, and more importantly, the reality of justice for all cannot be deferred any longer. We see the existential threat of climate crisis that poses to our planet and everywhere we turn, with more severe floods, stronger hurricanes, more intense wildfires. We just have to open our eyes. We've just witnessed images that we've never imagined, images that now we'll never forget. A violent assault on the U.S. Capitol, on our assault on our democracy, on our Capitol. A violent attack that threatened lives and took lives. And we know now we must confront and defeat political extremism, white supremacy, and domestic terrorism. For so many in our nation, this is a dark, dark time. So where do we turn? Faith. Kierkegaard wrote, "Faith sees best in the dark." I believe that to be true. For me, in the darkest moments, faith provides hope and solace, provides clarity and purpose as well. It shows the way forward. As one nation in a common purpose, to respect one another, to care for one another, to leave no one behind. These aren't Democrats or Republicans going hungry in our nation. They're our fellow Americans, fellow human beings. They aren't Democrats or Republicans going without health care in America. They're our fellow Americans, fellow human beings. There aren't Democrats or Republicans being evicted from their homes. They're fellow Americans, fellow human beings. And these aren't Democrats or Republicans losing their lives to this deadly virus. They're fellow Americans, fellow human beings. This is not a nation that can or will simply stand by and watch this. That's not who we are. It's not who faith calls us to be. In this moment, we cannot be timid or tired. We have too much work to do. And it's by our work, not just our words, that we're going to be judged. You know, but as tough as the times are, I believe, as a matter of fact, I know we're going to get through all of this. We'll come out stronger for it. The Bible tells us, weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. We still have in front of us many difficult nights to endure, but we'll get through them together. We'll need one another. We need to lean on one another, lift one another up, and with faith, guide us through the darkness into the light. May God bless you all, and may God protect our troops.